My name is Sarah Nandudu. I come from Uganda. I'm a member of the National Slum Dwellers Federation of Uganda, and I'm the vice chairperson of the federation. I come from a settlement called Chimaka, Mijinja, and I have a saving group where I belong to called Ambapot, or bring Ambapot members to meet. Just to share briefly what we do as a federation or as an organization, our major aim is to mobilize communities or mobilize people who stay in slums into saving groups. The major agenda is to transform our settlements. Looking at what has been before, it's like nobody seems to understand that we have a challenge in slums. So we have come up with a process of mobilizing ourselves into saving groups. Now, saving groups is just the start of our journey. As we mobilize people into saving groups, they come in big numbers, they come and build an agenda around their settlements. We discover that in a community we have like 4 or 5 saving groups. These saving groups come together, they come to save, and as they come to save, they also discuss on issues that affect their settlement. In essence, they come up to identify challenges through data collection. And this is a process we are calling knowing your city. So as you collect data, data concerning how many settlements, data concerning how many toilets, data concerning how many land titles that people have in the settlement, data concerning how much water taps they have, do they have drainages, do they have water, all this information we have for ourselves. Now, it will surprise you to know that many of our cities know that the slums are part of cities, but they don't even have an agenda on how to transform their settlements because they are overwhelming and they seem not to understand that they have a role to transform the settlements. So through SDI methodology, we are coming up to identify our challenges by collecting information that concerns us. First, before you transform any settlement or you have any plan for any settlement, you must have a basis, and this is what we call data. So the data we collect is able to inform any development that takes place in our cities. An example of our city is Jinja. When we collected data in 2009, supported by Cities Alliance on a program called Transforming Settlements in the Urban Area, this data, we worked it in conjunction with the local councils, and we all agreed that it was a true data. In the end, we verified it together with them. They brought it up and they took it up as a serious data that should inform the implementation of slum upgrading in our settlements. So through this data, we are able to have a partnership with the local government, able to have a dialogue with local government and all stakeholders in the council or in the municipality towards transforming our settlements in Uganda. So as I speak now, if we are to realize the outcomes of this agenda or the UN agenda towards sustainable cities, we should put in place actions that are really tangible and realistic. For example, you cannot leave the communities behind and you need to transform their communities. The outcome of this agenda will be realized on the communities themselves, meaning they cannot be left out. They have to work hand in hand with councils, work hand in hand with their communities, work hand in hand with all stakeholders in the government so as to transform our settlements and be able to realize the urban agenda. Through this process, we are calling upon all stakeholders, all the municipal leaders, all the local leaders, the national governments, the international multi-sectoral leaders and sects to join hands with whoever is in the settlements, whoever is in the city, so that we all achieve city for all or inclusive cities through inclusive and participatory approach which will enforce development in our cities. Without that, it will be difficult to really implement what we are calling the new urban agenda. Because